Netflix, the story of a movie rental service turned tech giant, a superpower of modern cinema in North America, and pause. I'm not telling you guys anything you don't know. Let's fast forward to what we actually came here for. This is a story of conflict between anime and Netflix, and why the two styles of media don't mesh, and why there is so much conflict between Netflix and the anime industry, and understanding the fan base that's grown up around the anime industry. Now let me start off by saying, I'm actually a really big fan of a lot of the anime that Netflix has made. I love Doridoro, I'm a huge fan of Beastars, I really enjoyed Aggretsuko and The Great Pretender, and I like how Netflix is making it a priority to make anime more diverse, appeal to different audiences, and to really just kind of offer some diversity in the anime industry, and to offer anime fans new and old alike anime that may never have gotten made otherwise without their intervention. There's also the fact that this increased investment in the anime industry will hopefully allow anime studios to become more profitable and more autonomous, and perhaps one day be able to fund their own projects in anime. Plus, having more players involved in an industry and competing with one another almost always promotes innovation and new advances in that medium, and that's why I'm so excited to see Netflix getting so involved in anime and investing so much within that industry. However, having said this, the problem is that anime doesn't really fit the Netflix model. Netflix, more often than not, prioritizes bingeable content, content that can be watched in one sit-through rather than waiting on each individual episode to come out. Now, there's several reasons for doing this. Number one, it makes shows easier to analyze and gather data on. And number two, it allows shows to build up a lot of hype really quickly and for the audience to circulate it on their own. You also have the fact that some shows just play better when they're binged. For example, Breaking Bad was basically saved by Netflix by following this format.
You're goddamn right.
However, this conflicts with the anime community that has a long history of circulating and streaming new episodes as soon as they could with their friends and communities in whatever outlet they could. I mean, not too long ago, the only way you could watch certain shows was through illegal websites, and this played a big part in forging the original anime communities, and there's something really cool about just waiting for that new episode to come out and to see what's gonna happen. With Netflix competing with sites like Crunchyroll, Funimation, that sometimes subtitle anime within hours of their air date, which is crazy, Netflix is left at a disadvantage and far behind their competition. Needless to say, this leaves fans like me avoiding spoilers like the plague and having a moral battle just about every day to not go to illegal streaming sites. In fact, what's worse is the fact that this has caused almost a resurgence of illegal streaming sites and is pushing a lot of anime fans over to illegal streaming sites to watch the latest Netflix anime. And this really concerns me because I enjoy these anime. I enjoy a lot of the stuff that Netflix is producing, and I'm afraid that this may destroy some of the anime series that have been doing so well because people are just going to illegal streaming sites rather than going through the trouble of streaming through Netflix or waiting extremely long for the latest subtitled version of their favorite anime. And something that really bugged me, I actually wanted to see if the Japanese version of Netflix would have a subtitled version of something like Beastars, because if you guys follow the channel, you're probably very aware I'm a huge fan. It was no surprise there wasn't a subtitled version, but I was surprised to see that the latest episodes of Beastars was actually being uploaded in the Japanese version. And as I just mentioned before, Crunchyroll, Funimation, all these streaming sites upload subtitled versions of the latest anime extremely quickly with the latest airtimes. But it's almost like Netflix doesn't even care. Just because these anime don't fit within their model, they choose to hold it back and keep it from their foreign audiences, which Netflix is constantly promoting but actively depriving from the latest anime. And the thing is, I want these anime to succeed. I want them to do well. But it all rides on if Netflix can adapt their model and adapt to the changing times, to see how the anime community grew in foreign audiences, how it cultivated in North America and all across the world. I want Netflix to be a part of the anime community, and I want to see the anime industry just continue to grow. But one thing about it, when some of the most popular shows in North America are anime, and some of Netflix's best performing shows are also anime, Netflix has to realize the importance of this decision if they're going to stay competitive for the foreseeable future. But in all reality, there's only one thing I care about. I gotta get my second season of Beastars. My anime people, thank you so much for stopping by. I really appreciate it. It's been a bit of a crazy time, but I'm happy to have made this one and had a lot of fun with it. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what you thought in the comments below. And if you haven't already, definitely like and subscribe. I appreciate you guys. Stay well in this crazy world and take care, my anime people. Peace out.